Applications, especially enterprise-focused ones, often have functionality that is best configured by IT admins rather than the end user. Think of server URLs, domain names, whitelists, blacklists, enabling encryption, even usernames and passwords for new users. I'm Rich Heinemann, and this is part two of my Android for Work series, where I'll cover app configurations, testing, and launches. If you haven't seen part one yet, you can find it here. We included new APIs in Lollipop for per application policies. They allow you to specify features of your app that are remotely configurable by IT admins. You specify the restrictions in your Android project in an XML file, and they're made available to IT admins in their mobile device management console. You can retrieve the current values at runtime by getting an instance of the restrictions manager and calling get application restrictions. Of course, if you do that on initial launch, you'll find any existing restrictions set by the admin, but they can be updated at any time, so you should also register for the relevant broadcast so you're notified if an admin updates the policy and then you can load the new values. Fortunately, you don't need to remember any of that. It's all detailed in the Implementing App Restrictions page, and there are sample implementations available as well. Just head to developer.android.com/work for all the resources. Testing your production code is always tricky, and regardless of whether you're using app configurations or not, it is good practice to test your app in a managed profile environment. Android Work has put together some useful tools to help you out. Firstly, you will need to set up a managed profile on your device or emulator. You can do that with the basic Managed Profile Sample app. Just click on Import an Android Code Sample in the Android Studio launch screen. It demonstrates how to configure which apps are available in the Managed Profile and which intents can cross from one profile to the other. Next, of course, you'll need to install your application. And once you have a Managed Profile on your device, any apps that you sideload are installed into both the profiles. So then you need to choose which profile you're running the application as. And you do that with the user parameter on the ADB shell commands. To find the user ID of each profile, there's a list users command. The first number on each line returned is the user ID. If your app relies on the camera or any of the default apps, then it's worth disabling them and testing. Finally, a quick note for developers of launchers. Launchers replace the default home screen on an Android device, and they provide for awesome customizations. And as you can imagine, displaying a view of two profiles merged together requires some minor updates. As shown in the first episode, corporate apps now have a special badging. Android 5 introduces the Launcher Apps class, which you can use to find all the activities available for the current user. Just call launcherapps.getActivityList with a null package name. And as managed profiles can be added and removed at any time, you'll also want to register for the profile added and profile removed callbacks to keep the UI up to date. Then, there are methods for obtaining badge versions of icons and also specially badged text for the content descriptions to ensure your launcher also functions correctly with the accessibility tools. If your launcher supports widgets, there are also a couple of new methods in the App Widget Manager for dealing with multiple user profiles. That's all. Thanks for watching, and let's get back to work.